this morning. Revelation chapter 6 from verse 1, I'll read to verse 4. And I saw when the Lamb had opened one of the seals, and I heard as it were the noise of thunder, one of the four beasts saying, "Come and see." And I saw and beheld a white horse, and he that sat on him had a bow, and a crown was given unto him, and he went forth conquering and to conquer. And when he had opened the second seal, I heard the second beast say, "Come and see." And there went out another horse that was red, and power was given to him that sat thereon to take peace from the earth, and that they should kill one another. And there was given unto him a great sword. Then over in St. John chapter 14 and verse 18, "I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. Yet a little while, and the world seeth me no more, but ye see me. Because I live, ye shall live also. At that day, ye shall know that I am in the Father, in my Father, and in me, and I in you." May we bow our heads everywhere. O great God and our Father, Lord, we're gathered together here this morning, united with one heart. Lord God, and if there's any other reason we are here, O God, than to hear from you, then Lord God, we know that we're at the wrong place. But Lord God, may we come, O God, with that one heart and one accord to hear you speak, O God, to us this morning. And Lord God, like they said of old, when you speak, Lord God, may we hear you and may we respond to your word. Heavenly Father, we pray, O God, that you'll take from us, O God, this morning, all the knowledge and the earthly knowledge of man, the wisdom of man. But Lord God, may we learn Christ by revelation this morning. The Lord God, we pray that the eternal God would become substance to our being, that, oh God, we can lean upon you, we can feed upon you, we can heed from you this morning. Lord Jesus, we pray that, oh God, you'll become such substance in our lives that, Lord God, all that we stand in need of, may you grant it to us, God. May we, oh God, draw water from the rock, that eternal rock that Moses struck, that he did not see the land, yet, Lord God, you preserve his life. And, oh God, he came and stand with you with Elijah at your adoption, oh God. Lord, may that eternal God stand with us this morning. And, Lord God, may you take all that we have, oh God. And, Lord Jesus, may you minister to us yourself, the person of Christ. The Lord God, we will leave with a different feeling, a different understanding. Lord God, a new man to worship you, God. Bless us now, God. Remember the sick, the afflicted, those that are without this morning, that, Lord God, you be Jehovah Rapha. Oh, God, our provider. Lord Jesus, our healer, our provider, our problem solver. Lord, we cry out to you, God. Come on the scene, oh God, and Lord, may you change the atmosphere for us this morning. Lord Jesus, we pray if there's a sinner, may they hear from you this morning. Lord God, if there's a person here this morning with a need, Lord God, may you minister to that need. Bless us now as we look to you and believe you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. In St. John 14 and verse 19, the Bible says, "Yet a little while, and the world seeth me no more, but he see me. Because I live, he shall live also." You know, the Bible said, "Whosoever live and believe shall never die." Hallelujah. I'd like to speak this morning on the incarnated Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. The incarnated Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. And the subject this morning, the mystery of the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Amen. You know that, you know, modern events being made clear by prophecies. That there's, the Bible said there's no new thing under the sun. Anything that you see today, whether it's in world politics, whether it is social, world finances, amen, these things were foreordained by God. They were prophesied by the prophets. And all that we see today is God unfolding himself, the eternal God that once, amen, they say was, amen, it still is, because he's eternal God. Hebrews 13:8 says he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He changes form, but he never changes nature. Is that right? We can identify Christ in Genesis, in the first chapter of Genesis, Genesis 1:1. The Bible says, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. We can identify Christ, the Word, because Christ means the anointed one, the anointed Messiah. Are you there with me? Amen. And all that God is doing, amen, we say that he's condescending. In other words, he's moving from a position of superiority and he's coming down, amen, to patronize you and I. Amen, that you and I can, amen, get to a position where we can see God. We can feel God. We can move by the impulse of God himself. Amen, that God can inhabit our beings. Amen, that you and God can become one. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. God, the hallelujah. When the scriptures were written, some men say that, amen, man write the Bible. But I would have them to know this morning that, hallelujah, the Bible said holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. And if a man is moved by the Holy Ghost, it's not man speaking. It's not man writing. Amen. But deity has come down, amen, to live with you and I. So the Bible is not like any other book. It's not just a book of history. Yet there's history to the Bible. It's not just, amen, a book about God. No. But it's the unveiling of the mystery, amen, of the eternal God. Amen. Coming down to you and I. Amen. That you and I can know who God is. And if we know who God is, then we understand the relationship between us and God. Are you there with me? Hallelujah. Amen. You don't know who you are until you know who your God is. And the Bible declare, we shall know our God and we shall do great exploits. Are you there with me? Hallelujah. In Amos 3:7, the Bible said God will do nothing, but he reveal his secret unto his servants, the prophets. Are you there with me? Therefore, we can say this morning that Abraham talk about him. Amen. We can say Isaac talk about him. Amen. Jacob talk about him. Hallelujah. Moses talk about him. Jeremiah prophesy about him. Hallelujah. Isaiah prophesy about him. So we said that God, amen, is a central theme of the Bible. Brother Branham said, if you ever read a verse of scripture and didn't see God in it, he said, go back and read it again. Hallelujah. But this morning I'd like to bring to a position, amen, that you can know your God. Is it right? Hallelujah. In the book of Hebrew, the Bible said God would sundry times and in diverse manner speak unto the Father by the prophets. In these times speak to us by his Son, Jesus Christ. Are you there with me? We don't do away with the prophets, but the focus of the prophet is not like the Old Testament. Amen. Today they're talking, amen, about the one, the form that God is in. He's talking about God himself. Amen. God in Christ. Are you there with me? Hallelujah.
Because Jehovah of the Old Testament is Jesus of the New Testament. Amen. That's why we don't say Jesus only. No, we don't believe that doctrine. He was God in creation. Jehovah God, Elohim, who dwell by himself. Amen. Becomes God because he created attributes to worship him. Hallelujah. He was Jesus in redemption. And now he's a Holy Ghost, the comforter with you and I. He's Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. He's a right. Hallelujah. Now there, you see the devil hate two books of the Bible. He hate the book of Genesis because it tells of his origin. And he hate the book of Revelation because it tell where he ends. Are you with me? Hallelujah. Amen. But Paul, as we read, hallelujah, in Corinthians this morning, amen, the mystery which has been hidden from ages and generation is now made manifest to the saints. Is that right? Hallelujah. Amen. We found there, hallelujah, clear, hallelujah, picture of God himself, where John wrote in the Revelation, and John said, and I, John, who am your brother and companion in tribulation. Amen. He's trying to tell you and I, I'm a man like you and I, amen, of like passion. Are you there with me? But he said, I was on the isle that is called Patmos, amen, for the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. John began to show and to speak of the things that he see and the things he hear. Now what God does, he bring it to John in symbols. Is that right? Hallelujah. Amen. So John say it, but yet John didn't understand. John wrote, but John never had a revelation. Because the Bible said to John, he said, seal up those things which are seven thunder hotter and write them not. Hallelujah. He said to Daniel, he said, seal it up until the time of the end. Men shall run to and fro and knowledge shall increase. Oh, hallelujah. They can tell you more about the history of the Bible, but yet they know less about God himself. Is that right? For theology is not an explanation of God. It is by man's wisdom. And God's not known by man's wisdom. All that day when he asked a question and he gave them the answer to the question, he said, who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? Hallelujah. And they said, some say you're Jeremiah, some say you're Elijah, some say you're one of the prophets. But he looked at Simon and said, who do you say that I, the Son of Man, am? Hallelujah. The answer wasn't the question, but yet it was hidden. Are you there with me? Because head knowledge couldn't bring it to him. And he said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. He said, blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father which is in heaven. Hallelujah. And upon this rock, which rock? The revelation. Revelation is a rock. Is a rock. Peter, you're a little stone. But upon big rock, the rock of revelation, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. The Catholic Church says the church is built upon Peter. That's error. Hallelujah. The church is built on revelation, divine revelation of who Jesus is. Oh, hallelujah. Glory, the incarnated Christ. Now I want to tell you, the Bible said, hallelujah, in Deuteronomy chapter 6, hear, O Israel, the Lord your God is one Lord. Hallelujah. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might. Are you there with me? Glory to God. Hallelujah. So there, amen, everything in the book of Revelation was laying a foundation. It was a stepping stone to tell you and I who God is and who you are. Is that right? And John said, oh glory, let me lay a foundation now. And John said, I was on the isle that is called Patmos, and I hear beyond me a voice. Hallelujah. And he tell all the voice that I'm Alpha and Omega. I'm the first and the last. What thou seest, write it in a book. Is that right? Hallelujah. John also tell you, and I turned to see the voice that talked to me. Hallelujah. Amen. That was behind me. And I saw seven golden candlesticks. And one in the midst of the seven golden candlesticks was like unto the Son of Man. Hallelujah. Because it was Christ in the midst of the church. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory. In Revelation chapter 4 and verse 1. Hallelujah. We find the first two verses. John was called, come up hither. Come up out of the church age. Let me show you things that must be hereafter. Hallelujah. And John speak of four living creatures that Ezekiel talk about. Hallelujah. One like a man. One like an ox. Is that right? One like a lion. And one like a flying eagle. Is that right? Then we come to Revelation chapter 5. And he said, a mighty angel proclaim with a loud voice, who is worthy to take the book? Hallelujah. And John said, none in heaven, neither in earth, neither under the earth was found worthy. Hallelujah. And John said, I wept. He said, then an elder touched me and said, don't weep, John, for behold, the lion of the tribe of Judah has prevailed. And any one of you know that the lion of the tribe of Judah is Christ. He has prevailed. Hallelujah. To take the book. Now watch this, no church. And John said, I saw a lamb. What a contrast. A lion had prevailed, but I see a lamb. Because before, hallelujah, there's a sacrifice. There has to be an offering. Hallelujah. The brother tell you last week, before there's a sacrifice, there's an offering. Hallelujah. But he said, this lamb, he was bloody. Hallelujah. And he went and take the book. When was this? Before the foundation of the world. What book it is? It's the book of redemption. Are you there with me? That's why we know this morning, you're not saved on a certain day, but you are saved before the foundation of the world. He's a rat. That's why Jesus could said, none that the Heavenly Father give to me shall be lost, save the son of perdition. Hallelujah. Glory. May I say this morning, you're predestined to stand. What word is that? Your destiny was determined beforehand. Can I say it like this? You're elected to stand, and you will stand. Your life this morning is not governed by what man say about you. Your life this morning is not governed by your critics, but in the mind of God, there's a pattern, there's a plan that is worked out for your life, and God's not looking, Hallelujah. Are you struggling today? But the hand of the display of your righteousness. Oh, can somebody praise God this morning? Therefore, when God look at you through the blood of Christ, he's not seeing your struggle. He's not seeing your broke pocket. He's not seeing the pain. He's seeing the blood. Hallelujah. And that blood was already shed before the foundation of the world. Your name put on the book, and the Lamb claimed the book. He opened the book, and your name that were sealed there. Oh, Jesus, you can step from the page of the book. Can I say this morning, I'm a tree of righteousness planted by the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Oh, Jesus. When John saw his name, when John see the book open, hallelujah, the songs change. It's no longer a wandering. It is no longer, oh, Jesus. That's why, oh, glory, the Bible say to you, now are you in heavenly places. Now. Brother Simeon, not when this trial is over, but now, therefore Jesus, amen. That's why I was telling Isaiah, when you go through the fire, when you go through the flood, oh Jesus, hallelujah, it shall not overflow you. Amen. What was he speaking of? Redemption. Redemption. The blood is already shed. The blood speak for you. Amen. May I say to your church, there's some trials this morning that is keeping you anchored to the ground. But you can rejoice. You can rejoice. You can rejoice. For greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Jesus. Jesus. And if you don't know him this morning, if you don't know him this morning, you're the reason he's still where he's at. Is that right? Because he's got to stay there at the seat of intercessory until the last seed receive the revelation of who he is. You said, brother, I'm baptized. That's all right. Hallelujah, you might be justified, but you're not sanctified. You might be sanctified, but you haven't received the Holy Ghost. Stay where you are. Press on. Are you there with me? Press on, for God's still working on you. Are you there with me? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. I tell you, that bad habit that you still have, oh Jesus, that cussing lip that you still have, put it under the blood. Put it under the blood, because he's still working on you. He's working out his purpose. Hallelujah. You've missed the joy this morning of your salvation, but keep pressing on. Keep pressing on. The devil is going to put all kind of trials in your way, all kind of blockage in your way, but keep pressing. Keep pressing. Hallelujah. For they that believe in God shall never die. Hallelujah. Glory. When Job was down and he was down on his face, Job said, I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand in the last day. That is my Redeemer. But then Job said, and though the skin worms destroy my body, yet in my flesh. Hallelujah. Skin worms destroy my body, yet in my flesh, I'm going to see my God. Job believed in a restoration. Hallelujah. Glory. Amen. I tell you, you're getting whole. Your back's bending. You're going back to the ground. You're slower than you were yesterday. But cheer up, my child. Amen. Because there's a restoration that is coming. Amen. God said, I will renew your youth like I've done to the eagle. And I tell you, heaven and earth will pass away. But God said, but my word My word cannot pass away. Hallelujah. Don't wait until you feel it. Don't wait until you see it. Take the written word of God. It can defeat the enemy anytime, any place, on any ground. If God say, oh Jesus.
Hallelujah. 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 Jesus. Amen. Jesus. Hallelujah. Now Revelation 12 tell us, hallelujah, that Satan was cast out of heaven and come down to the earth. The Bible call him the accuser of the brethren. Is that right? Who accuse you before God day and night. Is that right? Amen. May I tell you, as long as you're in the faith, you're going to have trials. You're going to have testing. Brother Smith, that's not the last one. As long as we're here, you're going to see some more. Are you there with me? But keep pressing on. Is that right? For the trial of your faith, work at patience. And the Bible said, let patience have a perfect work. Is that right? Amen. The adversary, the devil, is out like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Are you there with me? But it's not over yet. Hallelujah. But there's one thing about this battle. Amen. You'll never be defeated because the battle is already won. It was won before the foundation of the world. It was won at Calvary. It was, oh Jesus, that day when you received the Holy Ghost, that battle was won. Oh Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory. The incarnated Christ. Now I want to look now at Revelation chapter 6. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You see, one thing you got to understand when you read the scripture, there is not one scripture in the Bible that contradicts another. Is that right? And nothing is there just for poetic writing. It is the word of God. And I saw when the Lamb, who is the Lamb? Christ. Is that right? And I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard as it were the noise of what? Thunder. Hallelujah. If you look at Revelation chapter 10, and when he speak, seven thunder utter their voice. And John said, when the seven thunder utter their voice, I was about to write. Is that right? Hallelujah. And he said to me, seal up those things which are seven thunder hotter. Amen. And so when he opened the seal, I heard in my ears, as it were, the noise of thunder. What was that noise? It was a voice of God. Hello? You remember when he met Paul, Saul, on his road to Damascus? Some say thunder. At the tomb of Lazarus, some say thunder. What was that thunder? It was a voice of God. Hallelujah. And so when the seal break, amen, the thunder, it was a voice of God. And one of the four beasts say, no, there was four beasts. The first one was a lion. Is that right? Hallelujah. The lion of the tribe of Judah. No, this is the spirit representing the power of Christ in that time. Are you there with me? And it was in the first church age. Hallelujah, you find, amen, they had a spirit like a lion. Is that right? Amen, they gave up their lives for the gospel of Christ. Amen, go read how the apostle died. Amen, some were sore asunder. Hallelujah, some were feet to animal. Amen, some were dipping hot oil. Amen, but it didn't matter. They had the spirit like a lion. That was the anointing of the time. We call that the combat beast. Is that right? But notice, and I saw when the Lamb opened the seal. So here stand the Lamb. He's opening the seal. Hallelujah. I hear a noise. Hallelujah. Like a thunder. Amen. And I saw, hallelujah, and behold, a white horse. And he that sat on him had a bow, and a crown was given unto him.
He had a bow. Then a crown was given unto him. May I say, he had no crown. A crown was given unto him. Are you hearing me? He had a bow but no arrow. He couldn't shoot it. Is that right? He had no crown. Oh, the Bible said, we are not king yet, but shall be crowned. Is that right? Oh, the royal diadem. Oh, glory. Amen. Now the Seventh-day Adventist says, this is a Holy Spirit. Is that right? Amen. But remember, the Holy Spirit and Christ is the same person. Is that right? And here stand Christ announcing, are you there with me? And the voice speak, is that right? Amen. Then I saw a white horse rider. He had a bow. Oh, glory. Amen. But hallelujah. He had no arrow, and a crown was given unto him. Amen. What it was. It was that which started out in the first church age, the church of Ephesus. Paul said in Acts 20, after my departing, grievous wolves gonna come in and scatter the flock. Men shall arise of your own brethren. Is that right? Speaking perverse. Hallelujah. Glory. What it was. It was a spirit. Is that right? It was just a spirit. Oh, in the first church, hey, we say it was just a saying. Hallelujah. In the first church, they said, you've got the, hallelujah, the deeds of the Nicolaitans, which thing I hate. Is that right? Hallelujah. The Bible said, and he went forth conquering and to conquer. What is Nicolaitanism? It's to conquer the laity. Is that right? Amen. But this one that was conquering the laity, we said he was a bluffer. He looked like Christ, but he's an impersonator of the truth. Wait a little bit. I'm going to expose him in a little while. Hallelujah. Because he's moving and the power of God is moving. He's a rat. What started out in the first church, amen, is maturing. Hallelujah. It's becoming something. He's a rat. Amen. So he had no crown, but a crown was given unto him, and he went forth conquering and to conquer. What is the deed of the high church today? To conquer the laity. Is that right? Oh, did they conquer them in the early church, Brother Dixon? They took from them the word of God. And they said, you've got no power to interpret the word. We'll interpret the word for you. So the people, amen, do you realize in the early church, to carry the Bible was punishable by debt? Because the priest would say, the laity cannot interpret the word. We've got to interpret the word for you. Is that right? And you wanna subdue a people? Keep them in ignorance. Keep them in darkness. Are you there with me? Hallelujah. And that's what they did. But he was on a white horse. It looked like the elect, but it's not the elect. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory God. Amen. We gotta identify him. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And he was clothed. Amen. In Revelation 19, we're going to look at Christ, the Word. Let us see if this one looked like him. Revelation 19 and verse 13 to 16. And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood. Hallelujah. He was like the Lamb of Revelation chapter 5. Hallelujah. And his name is called the Word of God. But notice in Revelation 6, this one had no name. Is that right? And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. Hallelujah. And his army, which were in heaven, followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. Let us read. Hallelujah. And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that waiteth He should smite the nations. Go back. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron, and he tread the winepress of the fierceness of the wrath of Almighty God. Hallelujah. And he had on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of all lords. Hallelujah. Amen. You know what his name is. His name is called the Word of God. He is the Lamb. Hallelujah. May I say to you quickly, he's gonna become a lion. Hallelujah, baby. And thank God for the ministry of the Lamb, the sacrifice. Oh, hallelujah, the offering that is offered. Oh, Jesus, my Lord. Hallelujah. Revelation chapter 6 and verse 3. And when he, no, who is that he? The Lamb. For in Revelation 6:1, and when the Lamb opened the first seal, so when we got a first tree, and when he, the Lamb, had opened the second seal, I heard the second beast say, come and see. Ezekiel said the second one was like a ox. Who is a ox? A burden bearer. Hallelujah. Glory. Amen. And there went out another horse that was red. Hallelujah. And power was given to him that sat upon them to take peace from the hurt. Look what he was doing. To take peace from the earth. Hallelujah. And that they should kill one another. And there was given unto him a great sword. Hallelujah. But do you know the Lamb has a sword? In Revelations, hallelujah, 19, the sword, as it was, hallelujah, in Hebrew chapter 4, for the word of God. For the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than a two-edged sword. What is it? It's a combat battle. It's a rat. Hallelujah. He's got a sword in his hand, but the Lamb has got a sword in his mouth. He's a row. Oh, glory to God. He's taking peace from the earth. But the Lamb said, my peace, I leave with you. My peace, I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. Hallelujah. When peace is taken from the earth, the believer is in Goshen. Hallelujah. There's gross darkness. Darkness on the land and gross darkness upon the people. But in Goshen, there is light. Hallelujah. You can hear the crying. Amen. Down in Egypt. But the bride is not in Egypt. She's in Goshen. Hallelujah. Thank God for Goshen this morning. The revealed word of God. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Now we identify the Lamb. When he had opened the second seal, the Lamb. Is that right? Remember, he take the book in Revelation 5. Who is it? The Lamb. Who was he? He was bloody, meaning that he was killed. He's a sacrifice. He's claiming. Do you know in Isaiah? Glory. Isaiah said, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord in the temple. He was high and lifted up. And his train filled the temple. Do you know Isaiah said when he speak, the doorposts move. Hallelujah. And then the cherubim used a trunk and took a coal of fire and touched his mouth. And he was purged. Hallelujah. And the cross said, who will go? And as I said, here am I, Lord, send me. But do you know the word came to Isaiah? For behold, a virgin shall conceive and bring forth a son. Hallelujah. And his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. And the increase of his government, there shall be no end. What are we seeing here? We see Christ as one, and the devil running a counterfeit. Is that right? Hallelujah. He leaped from his white horse of deception, a spirit of Antichrist, and he changed to a bloody red horse. Hallelujah. With it, he created the martyrs of the earth. Hallelujah. Brethren, may I tell you, Satan has a twofold power in politics and religion. He's a rat. That's why I tell you this morning, politics is of the devil. All the World Ecumenical Council is of the Antichrist. No wonder Revelation 17 burst the bubble, Mystery Babylon, the great, the mother of harlot. Hallelujah. The abomination of the earth. It looked like righteous, but it's not. You know it? So ironic. Brother Branham said in the second seal, he said, oh, the head of every political power of all nation is of the devil. I'll say this. Hallelujah. For what it worth. I saw President Trump when he was coming in. Hallelujah. You know the first thing he did, he said, well, the Catholic Church has been put aside all this time. He's going to give the power back to the church. Hallelujah. And the next thing he said, he's going to make America great again. Hallelujah. And the nation cry out, and the church will cry out, amen. But brethren, I tell you, when religion is mixed with politics, it's the great apostasy. Do you know that? It's the greatest falling away that the world has ever seen. Amen. Oh, glory. But the Bible said the iniquity of the Amorites is not yet filled. Amen. But we said, fill it up. Hallelujah. Let them build the wall. Amen. Let them make that nation great. Amen. But I tell you what, Christ is still in power. He's a rat. They might have a Superman in the White House, amen, that will make America great, amen, but she's represented, amen, Revelation 13, I see a beast coming out of the earth, hallelujah, hallelujah, glory, horn like a lamb, hallelujah, hallelujah, you speak like a dragon, are you there with me, amen, what is it, amen, brethren, I tell you, amen, the Gentile days number, horrors and cumber. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Can I say this morning, hallelujah, the world has been gripped, amen, by fear today. Hallelujah. Amen. But I can tell you, something is brewing inside of the bride. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. It's putting on the pressure. Let them put on the pressure. Amen. We're being pressurized. We're being pressurized. Because why? We're going to leave out of here. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. You got to know where you're standing. Is that right? Don't let them fool you. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes, sir. Now, watch this now. This Nicolaitan spirit. It started out as a deed. Amen. Then it becomes a doctrine. Is that right? Nicolaitanism. That's why we're not a denomination. Is that right? The church would have had power except they put a man at the helm of the church that he as God speak like he is God. Hallelujah. And everybody looking over the Pope. But the daughters have done the same thing. They're fallen by the same thing. Amen. Hallelujah. The Catholic Church has got a Pope. Amen. Mean vicar of Christ instead of Christ. Hallelujah. But the denominations have got, amen, an overseer. A worldwide overseer. They've got a bishop in Pentecost. Hallelujah. Amen. That stand as a man. Amen. What a day when the man move away from the word of God. No wonder. Amen. They're so broken down. Amen. Of the standard of the church. Amen. It used to be the church of God. Amen. People would have dressed right. Oh, Jesus wore right, but not anymore. Because overseer, amen, has been energized, amen, by the anointing, amen, that is in the world today, amen. You want to pack, hallelujah, the chairs of the church, amen. Let them lower the standard of the church, amen. You want to know where a nation is at? Look at the women, hallelujah, amen. When women begin to dress like men, and men begin to dress like woman, then the spirit of Romans 1. Is rising up in the church. Are you telling me somebody? Hallelujah. Glory. When worldliness is a number one sin on the face of the earth. Amen. I tell you what. Amen. God said, I'm going to shake. All that is shakeable is going to shake. And the only thing that will not shake is the thing that cannot shake, which is the word of God.
Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Brethren, I tell you what. I'm not looking for redemption on this side. No, sir. And if it's going to come, it can't come through politics.
No, sir. No. Amen. Oh, glory to God.
Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus. I'm going to hit it now. You watch Nicolaitans. Spiritual antichrist. Pope, false prophet, beast, the devil himself, incarnated. Oh, Jesus. For the Bible now say, for he is God. Let us find 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. Oh, Jesus, my Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus. You got to know the day that you're living in. And the word of God that is revealed for this day. Hallelujah. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 3. Look what the Bible says. Let no man deceive you by any means. For that day shall not come except there come a falling away first. Is that right? Hallelujah. And that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. Look at now the characteristic. Who opposes and exalt himself above all that is called God or that is worship, so that he as God sit in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. You know, brother came to my office the other day and he was trying to ask my opinion on a certain thing. He's a young evangelist. And he said to me, he said, you know, I feel led by the Spirit of God to do some things, but he said, but you know, amen, sometimes the approval is not there. And he said that the head of the church sometimes is moving in another direction. So he said, so I said to my pastor, let us, amen, have some prayer and fasting in the church. And he said, pastor said, it's all right, brother, let me go pray about it. Let us go pray about the prayer. Amen. And he said, you know, he was working in another city. And he said, pastor called and said, amen, I want you to remember one thing.
He said, don't be like the politicians. Remember who appoint you. And I said, son, that's the problem with the church today. The Spirit of God is moving in a direction. But when a man set you up, amen, that man has a lead over your life. And so God can't talk to you anymore. Because, oh Jesus, my Lord, help me this morning. Because whatever bishops say, that's how it's going to be. Is a right. And sometimes bishop lose a focus like Eli. Amen, hallelujah. And he missed God somewhere. Woe be unto the church. Is that right? Hallelujah. Amen, you can't have what you want to say because, amen, from headquarters, there's a quarterly, amen, that is sent down. Amen, because we all want to say the same thing at the same time. Amen, and that's all right. Amen, but where does that leave the power of Almighty God? Amen, that something comes in the church. Amen, and God would want to talk about it. Amen, but the Spirit of God is bound. Amen, by ecclesiastical power. Amen, that is ruling the church. Are you there with me? Amen, no wonder Ezekiel tell them, I will restore, said the Lord, all the years of the Logos and the caterpillar and the canker worm and the palmer worm has eaten away. I will restore. Amen. And you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied. Amen. If you want to find the church, amen, that is bound, check the church of God today. Amen. Yet they've got many voices. Amen. That claim that they hear from God. Amen. But how can you hear from God? Amen. And not keep the word of God. Let every man's word be a lie. And let God's word be true. Hallelujah. Because he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And if Almighty God would come down today and speak again, he'll have to speak just as he spake 2,000 years ago. He's got to let the word of God live. He's the right. Amen. And may I say this, amen, by the Holy Spirit this morning. If you're in a church and that church won't let the Holy Spirit live, run for your life. For the Bible said, broad is a way that lead to destruction, and many there be that find it, but straight and narrow is a path that lead to life, and few. In the days of Elijah, God had 7,000. In the time of John, it was just a few. And in these times, may I say to you, it's going to be one out of a million. Hallelujah, Jesus. But God will never leave himself without a witness. Are you there with me? Hallelujah. No wonder the power of God is bound today. What you find is a lot of impersonation. Amen. Like it was when the seal broke. Hallelujah. Under the lion anointing. Under the ox anointing. Under the man anointing. Under the eagle anointing. Amen. But God is raising up, amen, a voice in this day that will have, thus saith the Lord. Amen. God's going to have a people under their messenger. They're going to be the final voice to the final age. Oh, hallelujah. I feel like Ezra this morning. I feel like telling them this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, like the Bible said, for you have left your first love. But if you would return and repent, hallelujah, God's going to hear you. Come on, church. It's not the time to just have church. It's not just the time to dress up, look in your mirror, and come to church. Amen. Now is God's time. God's raising up a standard. Hallelujah. And the Bible said, if the righteous scarcely be saved, then where shall the sinner and the ungodly man appear? Oh, hallelujah. What a day that we are living in.
Amen. I find today, amen, that people that should be going forward, they're going backward. Are you there? Many have lost, amen, their desire for the word of God. They've lost the taste. Amen. But I tell you, church, amen, I find out what it is. The Philistines are upon you again. The Philistines are upon you. Hallelujah. They're going to put out your spiritual eyes. Amen. But I tell you, like Samson this morning, will there be one this morning that says, Lord God, we've walked away from the mark, but once more, Lord.
Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. God works his place in a trinity. Justification, sanctification, and then he incarnate himself in this people with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. That's where I want to go to this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Let the prophet of God tell you. He said, what is a token? He said, it's the literal life of Jesus Christ in the believer. Are you there with me? Hallelujah. But the same thing the devil does. The devil is just a type after Christ. Satan's incarnate himself into his people. Amen. And I'll tell you, just like how Cain was religious, Satan is religious. Is that right? Oh, hallelujah. Glory. Just like Judas Iscariot, he went forth healing the sick, lay hands on the demon oppressor. Hallelujah. He was right there with them, but he couldn't go to Pentecost. Hallelujah. And before he meet Pentecost, he incarnate himself. Hallelujah. But Jesus tell him, hallelujah, I've not had 2 and you 12, and one of you is a devil. He said, man, whatsoever you do, do it quickly. Hallelujah. Amen. He said, the one that, oh, Jesus, I give the saps on like that. Amen. And he kissed him like Orpha. Hallelujah. He went out and sell him out for 30 pieces of silver. Amen. Isaiah said, amen, my real enemy is the one that walk with me to the house of God. Are you telling me somebody? The Bible said, not everyone that cried, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of God, but those that do it the will of God. Hallelujah. Oh, God, Jesus Christ, he's going to incarnate himself into his people, the very life of Christ. Hallelujah, is going to be in the person. That's why you cannot deny God's word. If a man stand before you today and tell you that divine healing is for another day, he's a liar. He's a lie. If he deny the promise of God for today, he's a liar. He's a lie. Let every man's word be a lie, and let God's word be the truth. Oh, Jesus, my Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. And if Christ is incarnate inside of you, what kind of life must you bring? If you take a grapevine and engraft it into a pumpkin vine, what will the fruit be? It will no longer be pumpkin. It's got to be grapes. Hallelujah. And the Bible call you the engrafted word. Oh, Brother Connie, that has been placed inside of you. Amen. You're going to bring forth fruit of his spirit. May I say this morning, the church is bringing forth fruit of the one that is engrafted in. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. That is why they're trying to stop God's word. Amen. That's why people try today, when you think they would have been way up the road, amen, try to tell you, oh, the word, it's not right there, it's not right there. Are you there? But I want every word of God.
is the right. Amen. The Bible said that, hallelujah, Satan take him up on a high mountain and show him all the kingdoms of this world and said, oh, this will I give to you if you'll fall down and worship me. And Jesus said, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. Do I have a witness of that this morning? If my life is failing, this is a tree dying, but there's another tree somewhere that has eternal life. Oh, hallelujah. Glory. Amen. He said, a little while, and the world said me no more. Hallelujah. No wonder Jesus tell him, I pray for you. I pray not for the world. A little while, and the world said to me no more. What is it? Separation time. Oh, glory. And this word come to separate a man from his church, a mother from a father, children from their parents. Hallelujah. To unite unto Christ, the revealed word of God. Are you there with me? If a man keep not this faith of Jesus Christ, walk not with him. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Are you still there with me? Hallelujah. Amen. Brethren, may I tell you, we weren't always righteous. We never come righteous. But thanks be to God who has engrafted his word inside of you. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Oh, Jesus, my Lord, hallelujah. Therefore, you're gonna know him, you're gonna know who he is. Is that right? He's the principal theme of the entire Bible, Christ. If you read the Bible and don't say Christ in every verse, go back and read it again. Hallelujah. If you can't see Christ in every verse of the Bible, amen, then you read it again because you've missed him somewhere. The Bible is Christ. He is the word. Hallelujah. When you read, in the beginning God created, you're reading about him. Is that right? He's the principal theme of the Bible. Do you believe that? He was in the prophets. Is that right? Hallelujah. He was in Moses. He was in Jeremiah. He was in Isaiah. He was in Abraham. Hallelujah. You think Abraham had some pitfalls? When he looked at Sarah and said, she's my sister, you liar. Is that right? Hallelujah. When he walked out of the land of promise, is that right? Amen. But when you sum it all up, when you look at what God's looking at, is that right? Not what man see, but what God see. When God tell Abraham, I'm going to bless you. I'm going to make you a father. And Abraham believe. But in Genesis 17, when God said, Sarah will have a son, Abraham laughed with his face to the ground. He can't look in a God's face. I can't believe you would think that Sarah, I could, but not Sarah. Because he saw Hagar and he see the seed of the bondwoman. Hallelujah, but Abraham should have known. Hallelujah, there's got to be a seed of the free woman. Is a rat. And I ask you this morning, look at your life, look at your failure, look at your shortcoming. Is there anything too hard for God to do? Hallelujah. If he saved Daniel in the lion's den, what about you? If he saved the Hebrew boy out of the fiery furnace, what about you? What about this trial? What about this test? What about this heartache? What about these crosses that you're carrying this morning? And every comfort of Job tell you, you're washed up. Hallelujah, you're turned down. Amen, nothing can become of it. Hallelujah, but you're like a little lily in the muck of the earth this morning. As long as the sun rise, I will rise again. And you're going to rise again with the power of the morning. Hallelujah. I shall not fail, for God can't fail. Woo! Hallelujah. He's your example this morning. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Can I preach?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. He's the glory of the believer. Is that right?
Amen.
That's why we're not looking for a Superman. We have one. Is that right? And Brother Branham said it takes the night to express the glory of the day. It takes the vessel of dishonor to express the love and the care of the vessel of honor. It takes an evil woman, amen, that would wear immoral clothes and sell her morals to express the virtue of a genuine, hallelujah, woman of God. Is that right? We should be identified with him. Oh, by living for him. Hallelujah. Not just a confession. Oh, hallelujah. But a conception. I'm in the church this morning. Not because I join. No, sir. But when I was a young man, I had a new birth. Is that right? And your first birth is nothing. Hallelujah. Jesus tell Nicodemus, you must be born again. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus, my Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Like the same way that the devil beguiled Eve. Hallelujah. That you might be beguiled the same way by the simplicity that is in Christ. For if he that comes should preach to you another Jesus. Hallelujah. You see, when Eve went away from the word, she went away from her mate. Is that right? And when the church goes away from the word to a denomination, she reject and commit fornication with the world of man wisdom. Hallelujah. Rejecting the authority of God's word. Is that right? Committing spiritual fornication. Amen. With the wisdom of man. Hallelujah. By rejecting God's word. Hallelujah. Amen. An adulteress never enter the kingdom of heaven. Hallelujah. We know that. Hallelujah. Amen. But he has to let and put man on free moral agency to fall so that he might be a savior. He's a rat. And he's not a savior this morning except you are a sinner. Is that right? And you are saved by the grace of God. You want to know the grace of Almighty God? You take the vilest of sinner in the book of the earth this morning. Amen. And I tell you, the love of Almighty God can reach him exactly where he is. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, the songwriter said, down from his glory, ever living story, my God and Savior came, and Jesus was his name, born in a manger to his own a stranger, a man of sorrow, tears and agony. But I can say this morning, oh, how I love him. Oh, I adore him. My breath, my sunshine, my all in all. The great creator became my savior. How many love him this morning? Because he first loved you. How many glad this morning that he showed Jeremiah the ministry of the potter and the clay? Hallelujah, when the clay was marred in the potter's hand, but the potter never threw the clay away, but over and over, God mold me and make me, hallelujah, a vessel of honor he wants you to be. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad this morning that he reached down his hands for you? Hallelujah. I can say this morning, I was lost and undone without God or his son, but he reached down his hands.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's why the songwriter said, but when I sing salvation, all angels flow their wing. For angels never know the joy salvation bring. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God didn't cause Adam to fall. He put him on three moral agents and knowing that he would fall. Hallelujah. And when he fall, God could have just drive him out. But he made a way. Is that right? Hallelujah. Before he kill a lamb and cover him. Is that right? And though he guarded the way to the tree of life, that they could not step back and live. Amen. But he made a way for you and I. Hallelujah. That same tree. Hallelujah. That was guarded by the flaming sword. Amen. Do you know Moses up on Mount Sinai? He saw that flaming bush. Hallelujah. Amen. And God speak out of the bush. He said, take off your shoes, for even the ground that you're standing is holy ground. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Yes, sir. Amen. Now you see the secret. Hallelujah. To restore fallen Eve as she was a prefigure of the church. And now notice as God opened up the side of Adam and he take Eve out of Adam's side. Do you know when Christ was on the cross? Hallelujah. Amen. The custom was they would have break his leg. Oh, but the scripture had to be fulfilled. Amen. They couldn't break a bone. None of his bones shall be broken. He was a psalm. And so they pierce his side. Why? Because you and I had to come out of him. Hallelujah, Jesus, my Lord. Glory to God. You're the fulfillment of scripture. You didn't come out by chance, but the scripture fulfilled about you. That's why the seals had to be broken. Hallelujah. That's why he preached six seals. Hallelujah. And there was no satisfaction for the seventh seal. Hallelujah. And Monday had to go to the hotel room and tell them it's got to be revealed. But from February 28, when the cloud came and they recorded. Hallelujah. July 28. Hallelujah. 5 months after. Five, God's number of grace. 28, the sign of life. For when he took his back to the tent, hallelujah, talk to message believers now. When he's back to the tent, talking to Abraham, telling him the promise, hallelujah. Amen. I said, Sarah, your wife, I'm going to visit her according to the sign of life. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, a woman that is past menopause, she has no more sign of life. Do you understand me? You understand me? No more sign of life. Hallelujah. And Sarah was old. Oh, well, Brother Smith, 90 years old. No more sign of life. I'm going to visit her according to the sign of life. We didn't know what that is. Brother Brad said, and the next 28 days, life sign came back in Sarah. Hallelujah. And to prove that she had a body change, they went to leave the land. And when the king of the country saw her, she was a young woman, more beautiful than all the wives and concubines, and he desired her. Amen. Is that right? Hallelujah. Life sign in Sarah. Can I say, church? And life sign is going to be in the bride. Oh, Jesus. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Hallelujah. So February 28, hallelujah, they saw the consolation of angel. Brother Branham said they never saw them coming. They saw them leaving. Is that right? Hallelujah. Amen. And 5 months from that, July 28, hallelujah, the sign of life, the seventh seal, now coming in preview. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. What was John saying? What was he saying? Hallelujah. Jesus, a uniting time. He was preaching Christ, the mystery of God revealed. And he said there's a threefold purpose. Hallelujah. that God might reveal himself completely in Jesus Christ, that Christ might have preeminence in the body of believer, that's you and I. When Christ take preeminence in your life, no more sickness will trouble you. You don't fear death. Is that right? You get to the place where Paul was. He said, oh death, where is your sting? And grave, where is the victory? For what purpose? They might take you back to Eden as if there's no fall. Is that right? Hallelujah. So July 28, he preached a message like he's never preached. And at the start of the message, page 10, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. He brought up brotherly kindness and love. Love one another. Above all things, love one another. He was fixing you and I for something. What is it? We are going behind the thick veil. The Egyptians that you see, you will see them no more. The trials that trouble you, they're going to be still there, but they'll trouble you no more. The heartache that you feel, hallelujah, you won't feel them no more. We're going beyond the veil. Hallelujah. What was he doing now? Hallelujah. You and Christ become one. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Something was fixing to happen. He's taking you and I back in the back part of God's mind. Is that right? Further than John had gone. John said in the beginning, but he said before the beginning, before he was God, when he was Elohim, when he was self-existing, where were you and I? We were a part of him. So in Genesis he said, let there be, and there was. The church say, who is he talking to? Who is the way? I'm a part of my Savior. I'm a part of his word. It's a revelation. It's predestined. Hallelujah. This is not the first cycle. We are in the second cycle. You bypass your theophany. You come into the world to be tested. But I tell you this morning, bride, we're going to leave out of here. Hallelujah. The secret things belong to God. But those things that are revealed are for you and I. Hallelujah. It's no more a mystery. You and Christ has become one.
Oh, Jesus. He said now, when Christ take you over, he'll express that word right through you because it's him. He is the word, see? And then you can see the expression of Christ, not some illusion of some sort, but a real genuine Christ expressing himself right through you. Is that right? Hallelujah. Oh, I'm going to say it like this now. There's going to be an incarnated Christ. For the Bible said, for when he shall appear, St. Luke 17, 30, for when he shall appear, you shall be like him, for you shall see him as he is. Jesus. Hallelujah. Look, Christ in you, make him the center of life of the revelation. Is that right? Christ in you, make him Christ. Hallelujah. The center of life of the revelation. Christ's life in you, make him the center of the revelation. Christ in the Bible, make the Bible the complete revelation of Christ. Christ in you, make you the complete revelation of the whole thing. Hallelujah. What God is trying to do. Look. Hallelujah. What is a new birth then? Jesus. The mystery of the baptism of the Holy Ghost. He said in the hint tab, it's not just the Holy Ghost, it's a token. What is a token? The required price for the journey. What journey?
We're leaving out of here. And the Mount Zion rapture showdown. We're going back, oh Jesus, to where we were before the fall. Is a right. What is a new birth then? You'd say, well, Brother Branham, what is a new birth? It's a revelation of Jesus Christ personally to you. For you shall know your God and shall do great exploits. Hallelujah. Glory. While he was preaching Christ, the mystery of God revealed, what was he doing? Hallelujah. Amen. On the seventh month, the 28th day, the sign of life. Seven is completion. Are you with me? 28, the sign of life. He was preaching the seventh seal, but it couldn't be preached without you being a part of it. Is that right? The mystery is not just on cross. For St. John 14:19, I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. Is that right? Hallelujah. Brethren, forget about your church. Think about Christ the Word. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you a little while. Hold on. A little while. Hold on. When the Word is restored to you. A little while. Just a little longer, Lord. Just a little more. In a little while. The world will not see me. The church think they have him. They think they speak for Christ. But he's no longer in the midst of the church. This is not the day of the Son of God. This is the day of the Son of Man. Christ behind skin again. Are you there with me? Who was he when he leave out of here? He was behind skin. And Christ is getting in skin again. In your skin. Is the right. The revelation is complete. The rainbow is now a circle. The covenant is finished. The bride and Christ has become one. That the bride will be. The bride is the incarnated Jesus Christ. It will be so close. So close. It will deceive the very elect. But the elect cannot be deceived. Why? Why? She's a word. She's a word. She's a, if he is a word, she is a word. Hallelujah. Therefore shall a man leave his mother and father. Eh? Hallelujah. Glory. Man leave his mother and father and shall cleave to his wife. And the two shall become one flesh. Hallelujah. Amen. It's the mystery of the marriage. Oh, that's why everything that prophet did, it had a purpose. He had to preach the invisible union. He was talking to you. The invisible union of the earthly bride and the heavenly bridegroom. The two has become one. Hallelujah. And what was he saying? Except the companion be dead, if she married to another, she shall be called an adulteress. Was that what he said? Is that right? And he said, now your first companion was your nature. Is that right? Some of you are still angry. Some of you are still fiercy. Some of you are still loud. Some still teeth. Is that right? But except the first husband be dead, if you're married to another, are you there with me? That's why we don't believe in reformation. That was for the church in the age until perfection come. But now that perfection is here, it's no more reformation. Are you there with me? It is conception. Hallelujah. It's not the earthly adoption. That you adopt somebody else's children. God adopt his own children. You're going to come to maturity in the word.
That's why he said you got to stay there under the presence of the sun to be ripened. Is that right? Let the sun bake out the greenness that is in you. You got to become Christ, the revealed word. Are you there with me? You say, I can't do it. You don't need to do it. Christ will do it through you. Because it's not you, it's him. What a day when you look in the mirror and you don't see Lambert Turner. What a day when you look in the mirror. Hallelujah. You don't see Ian Richard Simmet. Hallelujah. But you see Christ. Is that right? What a day when you look in the mirror and it's him you see. What a day when you walk out and it's not your walk. It's not pick a walk, it's Christ. What a day when you talk, hallelujah, and the sound don't come out like the way you used to hear it. It sound like a him a talk. Is that right? Because there's an incarnation, Christ in you, the hope of glory. Hallelujah. Him who is the image of the invisible God. Hallelujah. Now become the positive of your image. Because there's one theophany. And that's a theophany of Christ. Is that right? Hallelujah. Amen. And Brother Connie, we're getting to a place where not even death can stop the believer. For this is not the positive. This is the negative. Oh, Jesus, my Lord. Hallelujah. And he said even death will develop the picture. What a day. Oh, glory. Can I close with this? Brethren, I'll tell you, what are you coming to, Brother Key? We're coming down to a day when there will be no more sickness. Hallelujah. What is it? It is Christ being revealed. And he is the word. And when the word is revealed, it expresses itself. God's purpose for Jesus Christ was to express himself. Then Christ's purpose is to reveal himself in you. Why? Because we got to go back to Eden. Not the one with the fall. Before the fall. We got to bring forth children. Like Adam should have bring forth. That's why the children we're rejoicing about today is not those who are born by, hallelujah, the natural birth pain, but those that come by the word. Oh, Jesus, my Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. You're going to help me to settle down here now. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory. Hold me mule. Hallelujah. Because I tell you this morning, hallelujah, we're becoming one with Christ. Hallelujah. Jesus tell, oh, they come to Christ to tempt him. It has been said by Moses. But Jesus know who he was. Moses was the greatest authority that they had. And they said, Moses said, we're going to see what you're going to do. Because Moses give us this. Hallelujah. He said, Moses say, but I say unto you. Hallelujah. I was before Moses. I was in Moses. And I'm after Moses. Hallelujah. We got Abraham to our father before Abraham was I am. Hallelujah. Glory. You got to know who you are. Glory. This is time-tested memorial of God. That's why God said to Job, he said, gird up your loin like a man. Stand up on your feet. Let me see if you've got understanding. Answer me this question. Where were you when I laid the foundation of the earth? Where were you? Tell me, where were you when the sons of God shouted for joy? Hallelujah. When the morning star sang together, tell me, what was he saying to Job? Job, you are part of the letters. Hallelujah. I tell you this morning, what the church couldn't tell you, you and God become one by the word. Is the right. Oh, glory to God. So God had to send a voice to bring us back to where we were before, to let you realize that Christ is a mystery of God revealed, and you're a part of that mystery. All that was in God shall return to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All that God was, he poured into Christ. And all that Christ was,
He poured into you and I. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. That when you step forth, one of these days, what the world will see, the incarnated Jesus Christ on the face of the earth again. They have an incarnated devil. Hallelujah. A false prophet. Is that right? That had no crown, but a crown was given unto him. Hallelujah. We see him in the second seal as he ride out. Had no crown, but a crown. Hallelujah. But you've got a sword this morning. Not one in your hand, one in your mouth. Hallelujah. And I challenge you this morning, and when this truth is preached, it's going to bring a religious disturbance. Is it right? It's going to bring a religious disturbance. People are going to hate you for this word. Pentecost is going to be confused because they've got the Bible, but they reject the revealed word. Is that right? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. When you begin to let the pages of the Bible live again. When you tell them, hallelujah. And what then were you baptized? Oh, we're baptized by the church. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. You tell them that's just a title. That's just a holding place in the dark ages to hold you until the true light come. But now the true light is here. Every true believer must be baptized. Not must, not might be, must be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Tell me this morning, do you prefer the church or the word? Is that right? For if you prefer the church, you're going to take the tribulation with the church. But the bride will miss the tribulation, for she'll make it in the rapture. Did not the Bible tell you there is two resurrection? And the first resurrection is for the rapture. Paul said, I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not like them that have no hope. For if you believe that Jesus died and rose again, even them that sleep in Jesus, God bring with him. There's going to be a first resurrection. Hallelujah unto life. And for the second resurrection, you're going to be judged. And a shepherd is going to separate like one separating sheep from goat. They're going to be judged at the white throne judgment. But how can you be judged when you're already judged? This morning is your judgment. This morning you're tried by the word of God. It's either being your hands or it's on your heart this morning. What will you do with this Jesus that is called the Christ? The incarnated Jesus is here this morning. Can you recognize him? May we bow our heads everywhere. How many of you would like to be remembered? Just lift your hand right where you are. Even me, Lord, even me, Lord. Let some droplets fall on me. Lord Jesus. Lord, the Bible says, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither have it entered into the heart of men the things that God will restore to them that love him. Lord, what a day when the word is not just words on a paper, but it's living epistle that is read of all men. Lord, what a day when the word is restored and it's come back to power again. Lord, that which we stand in need of, we can speak the word and you will perform it. Lord, what a day when we step out of this cloak of skin that we're in, O God, and step into the dimension of God's word. What a day, O God, when sickness has no more victory.
where death is no more release and the grave has no more power. Lord, what a day when the bride is restored to the position she was before the fall. When, oh God, that voice of God would cry out to the ages, to the dying world, and says, live. Lord, bring your word back into the dominion of your people. And Lord, may the spirit of fear, oh God, go this morning. That, Lord God, men would seek to find, what shall I do that I might inherit eternal life? Lord, if there's one here this morning that has never been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, may they be convinced and concerned over their lives this morning. Because, Lord God, we know we're coming to that time where, Lord Jesus, it's going to be now or never. Where the Bible says, he that is filthy, let him be filthy still. And he that is holy, let him be holy still. But Lord God, I pray this morning that that hush of your word would come over your children. And may the conviction of the Holy Spirit, may it dawn a new day in the heart of the people. The Lord God, today they sit not in a church, but Lord God, may this be the word of God made manifest in the lives of your children. Bless us, God. Lord God, may this word live within us and live forever in our lives as a reminder and a memorial. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I tell you, if you're sick this morning, receive your healing. Hallelujah. And if you're a sinner, receive your salvation. In Jesus' name. You may stand.
Hallelujah. What a word of God. I don't know about you, but that meant so much. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. The blood that Jesus shed for me way back on Calvary, the blood that gives me strength from day to day.